One of the other big architecture pieces we added to help us scale was this notion of a pre-computed cache. We find ourselves running these queries to generate the hot page for Reddit over and over and over again. We may cache it for a minute, but then once that minute expired, we had to recalculate it. And we had a job that would, cron job that would run and just compute it and then put the stored value in Memcached. That worked okay. But then we had to do it, you know, we had all of our users' pages. Every user had their own listings of things they submitted and liked and their top things. And every Reddit had a new page and a hot page and a bunch of different sorts. So we started pre-computing everything. So the way we did that is we had this whole other database stack. These were replicas of the link database, basically, more link databases. They could lag a little bit. It wasn't a big deal. Every time a vote would come in, we'd put it in this queue. Queue is just a list of things to be done. So we'd have this machine that basically managed this huge list of things. And then we had a couple other machines that we called the pre-compute servers. And what these things would do is they would take jobs off the queue. This link has been voted on. Actually, what the apps would do is when a link was voted on, they would add like a number of jobs to the queue. And the jobs might be recompute Reddit's front page, recompute this user's liked page, recompute this user's top page, recompute Reddit's top page. There's all sorts of different listings that are affected by a particular vote. And these machines would pull off these jobs, and then they'd run those queries against the database. They would just mercilessly, as fast as they could, take a job off the queue, run the query against these databases. So these databases were really, really hot. No real-time requests, no requests from the internet actually ever touched these pre-compute machines. It was only these guys, these pre-compute servers would touch these pre-compute databases. And when the job was done running, we would take the result and store it in Memcached. And so that way, almost every page you looked at on Reddit would be fetched out of Memcached. There are very few things you can do on Reddit that would actually directly manipulate a database. And once we got to that point of scaling, things got a lot easier. These are really just kind of the last resort, like, primary sources of data, but any data you can access on Reddit in real time was actually served out of Memcached. Every single listing is pre-computed and stored in Memcached for Reddit on the whole site. This is the reason why now you can't go back beyond about 1,000 links on any particular listing. Used to be you could go to Reddit's front page and hit next, 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 and go all the way back to the beginning of time, which would just really, really trounce our databases, do a lot of damage, slow the site down, et cetera, et cetera. You can't do that anymore. We only store the top 1,000 for each sort, which is one of the limitations of doing this pre-compute thing. But on the upside, the cycle is very, very fast. There are very few legitimate reasons to go all the way back to the beginning of time on Reddit. Anyway, this worked out really nicely. And the site to this day still has this general structure, although a lot of the technologies have changed. And that's what we're going to talk Neil about.